Hey, what up? We're back with another video. I hate that kind of intro. Back with another video. How fucking original. It's actually a voiceover because my mic failed, so instead of having to go back and replay the whole thing again, I just thought I'd watch it back and just record my voiceover at the top of it. So yeah, I hate not doing it. Doing it live though, because I like to my reactions to be, you know, first time reactions, not just like, you know, watching the same shit over again. Yeah, so it's like some sort of Asian place. I don't fucking know. We got lasers in this one. Sharks with freaking
impressive
lasers.
They appear to be focusing sunlight into a laser-like beam.
Yes. Most impressive. Oh shit, the music starts. Dun, dun, dun. I love the soundtrack. Dun, dun, dun. Hook that motherfucker. Yeah, I get kind of like overwhelmed with this one. Look at all these guys here. Oh, see, that was a good shot actually. Took out two of those guys.
Take it!
Okay!
So they are pretty generous with the ammo. Ammunition in this one. I've actually got a new pistol in this one. Bought another pistol, I upgraded the hell out of it. Got more of a kick. Yeah, should have tried to hook that guy. The thing is, it's funny when you go back and watch it. It's like you can see like the mistakes you made. Look at this guy now. This guy coming from that. That's why I didn't do it. But yeah, no, should have purely missed with that. Quite a few things going at the moment on PC. That's all I know. Come on. Yeah, I can't give him a hook. Yeah. That'd kill that. You can't actually possibly hit that guy in the face. That'd break your whole hand. Yeah, so there's three of these emblems to pick up. Go back and get it. I realise. I walked down the stairs. I'm like, oh yeah, shit. I gotta pick up that emblem. Enigma. Did I pick it up? I can't remember. I don't know. I'm gonna concentrate. I think I already picked it up. Yeah, this is some top quality commentary going on here. Yeah, I already picked it up. Oh, did I? No, I had to go back and pick it up. Yeah, I knew off about it. Oh, look at the size of that thing. God. I can see why this game got... people thought it was racist. It's like, the people actually in Africa actually like... dress up like that. I mean, maybe some tribes, I bet they're quite primitive. That's from hearing from other African people, like, they're just like, they still like live off the land and stuff, but I don't know. White guy going to Africa, shooting up a lot of people. Yeah. Don't sound too good, does it? Tell you what about this, I think the environment, it kind of, you can tell like it's kind of aged a bit. It's all kind of dull and shit. It's crazy to think like how far I've come like with games though. Like, remember, like, I think I said this before in one of the videos, like, I saw Tekken Tag on the PS2 and I thought, fuck me, this game is like, and GTA 3 as well, when I first saw that, I was like, whoa, it's like, next level of shit. And it's like, then I got a HD telly. And I'll, yeah. I think the jump from standard definition to high definition, man. Kind of think I remember when I had the Gears of War, that's the reason I got an Xbox 360 actually before I got a PS3. So I just wanted to throw two games, Dead Rising, actually three games, Saints Row, Dead Rising, and Gears of War, and I'm just playing Gears of War, man, thinking, whoa. I actually got that game, I bought it again for the Xbox One, I bought the Definite Edition, I think it's called. Or Ultimate Edition. I'm gonna do a playthrough on that. Think about all those good Xbox games what came out at the time, and like, we had the Bioshock. I know it came out for PS3, but not straight away. We had the game Mass Effect. It's like, no, what do Xbox have? They've got Linux, they've got no. All I can get is time exclusives. Okay, the Force is good though, and I've got Gears of War 4, but yeah, I haven't played it yet, so I lent my Xbox One to me, a friend, so once I get that back, I'll play a bit of Gears of War 4. Just seems like PS4 is killing it. I'm not like sound like a fanboy, but because I've got both consoles, but it's like, I don't think there's many games coming out for the Xbox One. It's just like, Sea of Thieves, State of Decay 2, maybe Crackdown might come out. I'm trying to think what else is coming out for the Xbox. The thing is, the game, the backwards compatibility, which is nice. I'm just doing like a Netflix subscription kind of thing, where you got like, you can like rent games for like a month, or not like a month, but like, you pay a subscription each month and you can rent games, and like, they take games off each month, add new games and stuff like that. I think it's a pretty good, unless the game's like proper old. I don't know, even if they're old, I don't mind. I think it's only like £6 a month or so. We'll wait and see. I just think like all consoles should be just like backwards compatibility. They should all be backwards compatible. You should be able to pop a PS1 game into a PS4 and play it. I think anyway. I just think they do it on purpose. I think maybe, I don't know, maybe the coding, or like, I don't know, I'm not sure. It costs extra money. We should have to sell it back to you. You know, through PlayStation Classics on, you know, PlayStation Store. Try to get this one. Trying to find out where that guy's firing from. That's why I'm like aiming around. They're also the remake of Resident Evil 2, aren't they? For the I think it's just consoles, obviously. Yeah, I'm gonna say PS4. I thought it's got a PS5 exclusive going on. Xbox One, it's coming out on PC. Yeah, I'm taking my time here. So remember, like, when the PS4 came out, first game, obviously there were hardly any games coming out. I actually went back and bought an Xbox 360 just to play all the Gears of War. I played the second and I played the third. Well, I didn't play Judgment for some reason because I had that one as good. I don't think it had the original casting, I didn't think it had Max. But actually, when I bought Gears of War 4, you actually get all those games in your code, so I can go back and play Gears of War. Well, not Gears of War 1 because I got the Ultimate Edition, but Gears of War 2 and 3. I might play Judgment. I've actually got quite a few games on it because when you were Black Friday, I actually bought quite a few games. I've got Assassin's Creed Black Flag on there, which is a game but I've actually played a few times but never actually completed it, so I want to complete that because actually I'm not a big Assassin's Creed fan, but I like the pirate thing. And I got Halo as well, Master Chief Collection. I played Halo 1 because when I got the original Xbox, but I couldn't really get into it. I'll go back and give it another chance. Because I heard those games are like, not heard that, but you know what I mean, those games are like the highly thought of. Yeah, I say I heard. I've actually played the damn things, but you know, saw what the big deal was, but you know, give it another chance to try to be a bit more open, man. Yeah, because I remember I had a PS2, I had a few actually, and then I got like, they started doing a dodgy Ring of Death thing, not Ring of Death, but you'd put a CD into it, a disc, and then like, it just like, knacker it out. I don't know what happened to it. Now I got rid of my PS2 and I got an Xbox One. Xbox One, sorry, Xbox Original. I mean, I sold my Xbox and I got an Xbox 360. And then I got Skink, sold my Xbox, I got my PS3 where I used to work at a place that sold. I used to work at a warehouse that sold game consoles and used to sell, you know, CDs and DVDs and obviously games. I got it from my work for discounted. She dies here, I'm sure she's a Sheva. She fucks me over, she dies. Yeah, I got my PS3. I remember, I used to love Call of Duty Modern Warfare when I played that. That reminded me of like GoldenEye 64, but like online, and I was addicted to that shit. Like, Modern Warfare 1 and 2, for me, they're my favourites. Anything after that, yeah. I didn't mind Black Ops, but I just love getting the nuke on Modern Warfare 2. I actually went back and bought the Legacy Edition Call of Duty, but actually I kind of regret getting it because I only play it, I'm not as good as it used to be on Call of Duty, because it's the kind of game where you gotta just play it all the time to get like quite good at it. I go back every now and then, oh my god, there's spiders. Fucking spiders in this game. Yeah, I don't really play Call of Duty as much. I try and play everything nowadays. Back then I used to just play FIFA. Okay. Call of Duty. That's probably about it. But yeah, I've actually bought some new games on PlayStation Store. I bought Warriors. I bought Manhunt. I bought Sniper Zombie Trilogy, and I got Duke Nukem 20th anniversary game, which is like dated as fuck, it proper looks old, but I just wanted to play something a bit old school. So yeah, I got those, and also PlayStation, they've got a sale on for PlayStation exclusives. They got Nathan Drake Collection, they've got Last of Us. So yeah, I'm definitely going to be playing those on my channel. She dies here, she fucks me. You dead, Shiver? What are you doing? Yeah, she can't look at her, man. She's like limping. Oh, she's dead. I don't think it did anything. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I did it. I did it, but I couldn't remember. Alright. The music starts again. Yeah, I love Uncharted. I actually got into Uncharted quite late. I remember my mate from work went, you gotta try Uncharted. And I went out and bought the first one. I thought, yeah, we're alright. Bought the second one. I bought it pre-owned and then for some reason it kept crashing. So it kept crashing and I didn't get my receipt or something. So I traded it back to the place where I got it from, Computer Exchange. And then I didn't play it, and then they brought out the Nathan Drake Collection. And then that's when I played them all again last year, before Uncharted 4 came out. I thought, yeah, I've got to play these games. And yeah, they actually are my favourite games now. I don't think the gameplay is actually that good. I just think it's like the locations and like the storytelling and the characters. like these ancient cities and just like just getting to its character generally. It's like gets in these crazy situations. My favourite on chat is probably far, obviously. My opinion probably be different if I didn't wait so long to play it. I like the far from the third one as well because I like the combat in that. I like the opening scene in Uncharted 3 where you're in a bar and you've got a bar fight. It's a good cut. I like the combat in that. Feels like fluid. Right, I think I've got one more. You should pick up. Yeah, she picked it up. I got one more after that to pick up. No, I'm trying to do it. Yeah, I think I can't climb up there, but obviously I can't. Yeah, The Last of Us, I remember. I didn't play that on PS3, I got it the remastered one. And yeah, absolutely. That game is like, it's one, I think Naughty Dog, it's like, you're like emotionally invested in the story, man. It's like, some moments in there, I'm just like, wow. Again, I don't think it's got the best gameplay. I just think like just tells. I just think it's graphically, it's like fantastic. Like the characters are great, and I just feel like you know makes you like give a shit. I like the I'm not a big stealth fan, but I like the stealth thing in charge. That's I think that's good when you like sneak around, you like try to take people out. You know, it gives you the choice of if you want to play it guns blazing, you want to go out and go in and stealth it. But yeah, Resident Evil, man, I mean, I've only ever played Resident Evil 4, 5, oh, I played 6. I actually did, I played it and then I got bored. It was bad. It just felt like a shooting. I think when they split it up into four different stories, I didn't like that. I didn't like the Leon bit. I don't know, it just felt like a shoot. I mean, it felt like a Resident Evil game. Like, it just felt off. And then Resident Evil 7, absolutely. Oh, she got zapped. Resident Evil 7, I actually love that. Love that game.
Give me a grenade.
Take this.
I think there's some parts in Resident Evil 5, like with the monsters, they've got different, better variety of monsters. Definitely do it better. That's what I think it let down, and the ship part were a bit boring, a bit tedious. Yeah, they should have had more variety of monsters, but apart from that, better maybe some more bosses. Even though the Jack boss and the Marguerite boss were, I think it's Marguerite. I'm not sure if this is a cutscene here. Oh, it's not like anything. It's not anything major. It's like a puzzle. I think it's a puzzle coming up. Yeah. Oh my god, fucking spiders, man. Oh, they always make my skin crawl. I hate spiders. I don't think anyone likes spiders. Look at the size of that. That's a beast, that. Thinking back to when I played the remastered Resident Evil, the original spiders in that moment, they were so, the way they did the legs with the hair on, oh, made the skin crawl, man. Best spiders in the game. Yeah, I've played Resident Evil Revelations 2 and Resident Evil remastered one, but when the first one came out, yeah, it was probably on the first, I think it'd be about 1996 it came out, so I'd be like 7 years old when the first one came out, but yeah, I didn't play that one.
There's a trick to getting out of here.
And I think I played a bit of Outbreak on PS2, but I didn't have a clue. Yeah, I'm a dumbass, I walked straight into the laser. I remember dissing. I had a go at Sheva, like, she was like, oh yeah, it's a trick to getting out of here. I was like, yeah, no shit.
I see. There's a trick to getting out of here.
Right.
Tread carefully. Those beams are dangerously focused.
Yeah. I gotta say. Ooh, yeah, see that? I nearly like walked into it then. I'm not sure I'll die again. I'm not sure if I did I cut this bit out. Can't remember. It's like Silent Hill as well. I bought that on PS3 on sale and I went back and. I never played that before. I thought I'd go and play my man that game. That was hard. The aiming, just the gameplay. I just feel like games from the 90s. They just feel solid. I just think like games now, like when people go back and play them from like 2010 and stuff, like they just feel so much better. Yeah. Like some of those old NES games or SNES games or Sega.
Looks like it worked. Man,
like
finished.
Ghouls and Ghosts, man. That's like I never got off the first level. I don't think it's just like. That game feels impossible. I think they had to make them impossible though, because it's like, I think it's like, if you just wait all the way through without dying, think like, it's like a couple of hours long. That's not the show. Different now. Come on, that bad shit, mother. Yeah, I think I already spoke it on this one of these things about Resident Evil 4. That is like one of my top 10 favourite games. I think like top 10. My favourite game of all time is Silent Trace. I just feel like that game's like. That's definitely the best, in my opinion, the best GTA. Because you had the three cities, you had San Francisco, you had Las Vegas, then you had Los Angeles, you had the countryside, you had desert, you had the Area 51, you had casinos. Just felt like it was a mess up. If I remade that game to like, and they used the GTA 5's engine, like graphics to do it, might be so amazing. I did like GTA 5, but I do feel like it's overhyped. I might reckon San Andreas Vice City, and then I'd say GTA 5, and I'd say GTA 5. Well, actually not. Remember GTA 3 were like, wow, this is, I don't think I've ever played anything like this before. Like, I'd go up and sit, driving around, getting chased by, that's what I used to just do in that game, just like, I never completed GTA 3, because I used to like going on like rampages. I actually bought that on a Steam sale, GTA trilogy, the original trilogy, you know, GTA 3 by City San Andreas. So that's definitely a game that I want to do on my channel. Got so many good games to play. I wish you could play them all just like at the same time. Yeah, I did all the work. Come on, Sheva. Goddamn that bin. I think I'm going to go up. Like, old school games to me are like N64 and PS2, like, kind of generation. That's when I started, like, getting into, like, Super Mario 64 were, like, my first, like, proper game where I, like, whoa. I love that game. That's another top 10 favourite. It's just, like, that's a game where you could go back and play now. Not like GoldenEye, which is, like, hard as fuck to do any, like, aiming. That game feels like impossible to play. I don't think that GoldenEye hasn't aged well. Remember the like, that level, that, I think it was facility, you started off in like the air vent, you had to drop down to a toilet. If you did that in like under 2 minutes, you get like the, I think it's invincibility, or invincibility, yeah? There was two. Invincibility and invisibility. I remember my friend had one of those, come on, come down. Like a cheat thing. Could like, just unlock all the stuff. Can't remember what it was called, but it was a certain, I had a certain name, like, you'd put it into your, you'd slot it into your cartridge, and then you put, well, the cartridge slot, you put this cheat thing in, and you put the cartridge in, and it, like, well, you can unlock the cheats. Remember, I used to just tear it up on that facility, man. You could get, unlock all the guns, you get double machine guns, double pistols, double Desert Eagle. Remember, I used to get the golden gun, one shot, one kill. Multiplayer on that was sick as well, like, you get that tempo level, and you get the golden gun at the bottom, you have to, whoever got the, obviously got the golden gun, just like, kicked ass. Remember, I'm worried now, because I'm thinking it's like a boomer trap in this game. So I'm cautious, I'm like, oh, if I go into this room, will something happen? Will it trigger something? And I just didn't want to have to do this bit again. Because I suck at puzzles, even obvious puzzles. I am absolutely terrible. Like, embarrassingly terrible at puzzles. I just think too hard, you know what I mean? It's like, I seem to do the opposite of the obvious thing. Oh, snake! Another snake gets me as well. Right. I'm trying to slice it, man. I can't slice it, man. I'm shooting the damn thing. There we go. Right, it's gonna be a good snake. There we go. I'll get this one. There we go. Have another. Gold to pick up. Who are you? Oh, I've just missed some gold as well. I'm sure I saw it calling me, I missed some. And there's like a box there, but you don't open that box because that is a booby trap. I remember from the last time I played this. You open that red box in the middle, you open that up, you die. Come on. Where the duck? Yeah, I'm trying to actually, I don't know what I'm trying to, I think, yeah, I'm moving that out of the way so I can position this mirror and get that one into this corridor. Yeah, I've got to take it. Boy. Come on, one more. You do, oh yeah, got it. I think I got it. There we go. Did it. Yeah, and I meant to actually play Mass Effect this week, but I changed my mind on that game. That game was crap. I'm trying to say something positive, I didn't want to say it. Yeah, it's a shit. It just looks, I don't know, it just looks off. I'll maybe buy it when it's on sale, but that's definitely not like a day one buy for me. I'm actually going to get it on PlayStation Store as well. I'm going to pre-order it, but I'm still going to wait. Like the reviews came out early for that, early footage of that game, because like, I can't believe I messed that up, man. I'm disappointed. That Mass Effect, I thought it was gonna be like a 10 out of 10. That space exploration.
What is this place?
Survive underground.
These are no ordinary flowers. Wait. Oh,
What? What was Umbrella doing?
I don't know. It doesn't look like anyone's been around for a while.
You can be sure they wanted to keep this place a secret.
Some of this equipment's got the Triso logo on it. Are they working together?
Alright guys, obviously that's the end. Obviously I died a few times there, so... I didn't get the S rank. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed me blabbing on. I know, I'll catch you next time. Peace out, homies.